Hi friends, now we are going to start our SFM revision lectures that will be available on this channel on YouTube for your reference, and we will be starting the series in the flow of chapters that we have covered in our textbook as such. The first chapter with which we will begin our discussion is Equity Analysis and Corporate Valuations. So in this chapter, first part that we have is something that is theory related, and the second part of the chapter that we have is something that is everything practical related, right? So theory wala part, let us just discuss it in around 5 minutes time, just so that we know what is the theory that is a part of this chapter, right? Equity analysis is chapter ka naam, right? So can I say there will be an approach or there will be a method for analysis, right? So the first theory aspect that we had was approaches to equity analysis, and therein we had further divided our approaches into two parts. The first one being fundamental analysis and the second one being technical analysis. Sir, fundamental analysis, can I say fundamental analysis was nothing but understanding the basic fundamentals of any organization, like the composition of the company, the board of directors, the management, then the intention of the management, then the way in which that particular management is working. Basically, can I say us business ka funda samajhna hai hum log ko. Can I say we go to the roots of the business to decide and evaluate the equity of that particular company? Right, so can I say fundamental analysis would normally help us in pricing decisions, because better the intention, better the fundamental, can I say higher will be the price of the equity and vice versa, right? Second aspect was technical analysis. Technical mein we did not used to analyze the funda, but we used to analyze the past trends based on graphical representations, based on the movements in the market, based on the various types of pie charts, flow diagrams and various other statistical tools. Matlab, can I say whenever we entered into technical analysis, our assumption was always that the past trend will repeat in the future, right? So can I say jab hum trend repeat karne ki baat karte, can I say this is concerned majorly with timing decisions rather than pricing decisions, right? It will place more emphasis on the time when the trend will repeat in the future, right? Clear? Understood? Then we went ahead further with fundamental analysis. Can I say funda jab hum samajhte kisi bhi cheez ka, we start from the main thing and then we come down to the crux, right? If you have ever done any company audit or any tax assessment or any business understanding, you will first of all see that you first understand the country, right? Then you understand the industry in which the company is operating, and can I say then you go to the company level to understand what is the situation of that particular company and how it should be valued. Similar is the process of fundamental analysis, where we start with country analysis, then we move to industry analysis, and then we move to company analysis, and then we move to company analysis. Can I say what we have followed over here is nothing but a top to bottom approach? We studied the top and then we move to the bottom as such. Hum niche ja rahe hain. We are getting deeper and deeper into the details and into the litigities or the integrated part of that particular company from the country level now, right? And similarly, technical analysis में हम लोग क्या करते थे? कहने से पिछले graphs understand करते थे. पिछले graphs understand करने के लिए कहने से we used to make assumptions. And कहने से our assumptions would be that the first thing on which the price will depend is nothing but on demand and supply. Right? Demand supply पे अपना price of the stock will depend. Then कहने से we used to say that ये दो चीजें are governed by several factors. Right, there are various factors which affect the demand and supply of a particular stock or particular security in the market. Right, fir kya bol rahe the hum log, can I say the third assumption used to be that trends will repeat. We used to say that stock price move in trend and the trend continues for a period of time. Matlab implied assumption to wahi maar dete na ki trend will repeat in the future. And can I say the fourth assumption was that we rely on charts. and past data. Right. Uspe kyun rely karna padta tha? Because we used to make the assumption that the trend which has happened in the past will repeat in the future as such. Understood? After this in theory part, can I say the next thing that we did was some theories that governed technical analysis? Theories governing technical analysis. Right. Barabar. Theories padhi thi hum log ne. Can I say in that we had some major theories like the Dow Jones theory, the Elliott wave theory, then we had the efficient market hypothesis theory and the random walk theory. Right. So pehla theory kaun sa kiya tha hum log ne? Can I say we did the Dow Jones theory. Right. So can I say Dow Jones theory mein the first discussion that we had was about the type of market movements which Dow Jones had classified. He told there are three types of movement. One is the primary movement, one is secondary movement and one is daily movement. Wo kya kehna chahte the? Primary movement is this the movement which is the long run movement of the market. Matlab agar market bullish hai to in the long run it is going to be bullish. If the market is bearish, then in the long run, the market is going to be bearish. So can I say this is nothing but a trend which will be for a period of 1 year, say zyada ka period, right? A period more than 1 year, 236 months or even greater than that period, right? The next movement that he told is the secondary movement. But it is shorter than the primary movement and it is opposite in direction as compared to the primary movement. So, agar market bullish hai, to ye jo secondary movement hai, jo temporary time ke liye aaya hai, wo thoda bearish hoga aur fir market wapas bullish chala jayega. Right? So, can I say it is a movement which is opposite in direction to the primary movement and it is smaller in duration as compared to the primary movement. So, can I say it will last for max to max a year? Ya ek month? Kyunki pura agar mera year ki baat karu, primary movement pura saal ka main dekhta tha. Right, I used to see the market movement on the primary basis which used to be for a year or more. So can I say this secondary movement will be for an even shorter period of time? And can I say uske baad bhi there will be daily movements which happen in the market? Like we have this, like the heartbeat goes on the market on the daily basis pe. Right, this is nothing but the daily market movement which is then corroborated over a period of time to arrive at this movement, and this movement over a period of time determines this movement. Am I clear with what I have told? Right, can you say this is what the graph looked like? These were the minor daily movements happening. This is the primary trend that it is a bullish market. And can you say these are the opposite trends that are happening which make the market a bearish market? Right, he also told that there are three phases of any particular market. Like you have the accumulation phase, you have the public participation phase and the panic phase. Accumulation phase mein kya hoga? People will start to accumulate the shares. Can I say then that will make the market a bullish market? Over a period of time, the market will become bullish. Why? Because people have started participating, people have started accumulated, people have started buying the shares, right? But can I say it is a bubble that is being created? And can I say, jisdin bubble phutega, there will be panic situation. And can I say, someday or the other, the bubble will break and then we will enter into the panic situation, right? And can I say that will result in a distribution of whatever was accumulated by the people. Whatever you have accumulated till now, can I say, will now get distributed amongst all the people, right? That is nothing but our three particular phases of any market. Aur unhone kya bola tha? He told that there is a three trend market. There will be an uptrend, there will be a sideway trend, or there may be a downward moving trend. Then he told that the market discounts everything. Market mein jo bhi mil raha hai, wo aaj ki present value ke hisab se mil raha hai. The market is very efficient to discount everything. Volume must conform with the trend. Fir indexes must conform with each other and all of that basically is principle. And what did he tell? The trend continues to stay in effect till a reversal is very much visible. Matlab, can I say trend analysis ka ye to wohi bolta, trend will repeat unless a clear reversal is visible to me. Right? Agla theory kaun sa tha? Agla theory was the Elliott wave theory. He also told me the market has waves, but what did he tell? He classified the waves into two types. One was the impulsive pattern, that is the basic wave in which the market is moving, and the second was a corrective wave. Matlab agar kuch zyada hi upar chale gaye ya kuch zyada hi niche chale gaye to market khud ko correct kar dega after some period of time. So can I say if I look in this graph, 1, 3, 5 are normally a bullish market indicator, and it tells that it is an impulsive or a basic wave of a bullish market. Right? Can I say 2 and 4 are corrective waves for a bullish market? Because bullish ho raha tha, correct kar diya aapne, aapko to thoda bearish ho gaya. Right? If I see the aspect from a bearish market type of view, can I say 2 and 4 are the basic wave, because in a bearish market everything has to go down, right? But can I say then 1, 3 and 5 are corrective waves for a bearish market? क्योंकि अगर bearish market है ideally तो वो नीचे जाना चाहिए, but ये ऊपर जाके थोड़ा correct कर रहा है scenario को, क्योंकि कुछ ज़्यादा down ना हो जाए, so that it does not fall very low than what it should have actually fallen down. Understood? The third one was the efficient market hypothesis, where we understood that the market is of three types basically. One where it is weak form, one where it is semi-strong form, and the other one where it is a strong form. Strong form mein kya hota tha? Can I say the past information, public information as well as private information related data is already exhibited in the market price. Well, the market price is reflecting all the three types of data because the market is strong enough to encapsulate within itself any type of information available. Right? In a semi-strong market, hum log kya bolte hai? Strong hai, but itna strong bhi nahi hai ki that it reflects the private market price on its own in the current price. Matlab it means to say ki jab private information market mein public ho jayegi, market price will be impacted. Strong kya bolta hai? Private information market mein aaye to bhi farak nahi padta, kyunki pehle se hi that price is already reflecting. That information is already reflected in my price. And the weak form. Weak form kya bolta hai? Only past trend data is reflected in the price. There is no reflection of the public information or the private information of any particular entity in the price of the share in the market. Public information bhi kuch aayega, share pe impact aayega. If there is any private information which comes into the market, then also it will impact the price of the share in the market as such. Understood? Clear? And then we had the fourth theory, which was the random test theory, walk theory. Ye kya bolta hai? Prices in any market can never be predicted. There will be ups and downs, but there cannot be any connection which you can establish between the peak of one share and the lowest point, that is the trough of another share in the market. You cannot establish any link because market is unpredictable. People are very much irrational. People are rational, so everything will adjust itself based on the behavior of people. You cannot predict that a recession, supposing which has happened in 2009, will again repeat in 5 years. You do not know. It is unpredictable. That is what the random walk theory says. Wo ek bar hua, wo repeat hoga, maybe possible. Repeat na hoga, maybe possible. So can you see? Matlab ye kya bolta hai? Market is Ram Bharose. Everything will happen on its own. So can I say the fourth theory is to summarize or to remember during our exam is nothing but the Dow Jones theory. Then we have the Elliott wave theory. Then can I say what we have is the efficient market hypothesis theory. And the last one being, which theory? Random walk theory. Right? Can I say apna theory related main discussion ho gaya? Now we were basically into the practical aspect as of now, right? Abhi practical cheeze dekhni padegi, how we actually will do the valuation aspect now. Right, analysis ki to baat chal gayi, valuation kaise hoga, right? Can I say for that valuation analysis, we had basically got two models, absolute valuation models and relative valuation models, and relative valuation models, right? Absolute valuation model kya karta tha? It used to determine the value of a share based on the data of the company itself. Matlab, can I say based on own data, this analysis used to take place. Right? But in case of relative valuation, can I say what we used to do is, we used to do the valuation of the shares, we used to do the valuation of the shares based on the data of related firms. Right? आजू बाजू वाले फर्म्स के बेस पे वी यूज्ड टू डू द वैल्यूएशन. सो कैन आई से व्हाट वुड कम ओवर हियर इज नथिंग बट कैन आई से वन एग्जांपल बीइंग पी रेशियो, प्राइस टू बुक वैल्यू रेशियो, प्राइस टू सेल्स रेशियो, प्राइस टू एबिटडा रेशियो, etc. Can I say the valuations would be based on these various parameters as such, right? But जब ओन डेटा की बात चलती है, कैन आई से द ओन डेटा विल आइदर बी माई ओन कंपनीज डेटा, राइट? एंड कैन आई से द ओन डेटा कैन बी एनालाइज फॉर टू टाइप्स ऑफ पीपल? कैन आई से दोज हु हैव माइनॉरिटी होल्डिंग एंड दोज हु हैव मजॉरिटी होल्डिंग, राइट? अगर माइनॉरिटी की बात चलती है, कैन आई से ही इज नॉट कंसर्न अबाउट द कैश फ्लो जनरेटिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द कंपनी, बट व्हाट द माइनॉरिटी इज कंसिडर्ड इज कंसर्न बट इज अबाउट डिविडेंड, जबकि मजॉरिटी कैन आई से इज कंसर्न अबाउट कैश फ्लो. सो कैन आई से देन वी हैड गॉट टू मॉडल्स, वन इज द डिविडेंड डिस्काउंट मॉडल एंड द अदर इज द फ्री कैश फ्लो मॉडल और द एल्कर मॉडल ऑफ वैल्यूएशन, राइट? So now let's go to the dividend discount model. So can I say under the dividend discount models, we have three scenarios as such. The first one is that the company pays constant dividend every year. Matlab, can I say the firm is not growing? So can I say in that case, the price of the share today is nothing but dividend upon K. Matlab, what you are expecting, right? You are expecting 8%, right? Company gave dividend of 80. So can I say the value of the share 100% should be what? Can I say 80 upon 8% divided by 8%? Can I say 1000 will be the value of the share? This is the price of the share today. That is what is the simple understanding of this particular theory, right? Then can I say we have the next theory which told us that no, we are not giving constant dividend, but I will grow the dividend constantly every year. Matlab, my growth rate will remain the same. So can I say in this case the price will be dividend of the upcoming year, that is dividend 1, or can I say I write D1 only, right? Upon, can I say growth though will be reflected to that particular person in a way, but what he needs to be compensated is nothing but for the excess of expectation over growth. So compensate him for that difference in the market price. So under the constant growth formula, you have D1 upon K minus G, which is nothing but the value of your share today. Right? Can I say whatever we are computing as P0, all of these are theoretical prices, right? Actual may vary in the market, right? So tell me one thing, if the theoretical price is greater than the actual market price, matlab, can I say tumhare hisab se the share should be at 100, but in the market it is at 80, can I say the decision will be to buy or to go long on the share, right? If the theoretical price is less than the actual market price, matlab share ka value should be 80 rupees, but in the market it is at 100 rupees. So can I say the decision would be to sell the shares if you have or go short on the shares, right? Agar hai to bech do, kyunki kabhi na kabhi 80, matlab it will come back to what it is actual value, right? What is its actual value, uspe wo kahin na kahin aayega, it will come back to 80 and that time you will make a loss. To abhi 100 mein to bech do. Right? And can I say there can also be a case when the theoretical market price is equal to the actual market price? Can I say in this case my strategy will be to hold the shares? Because kharidunga does not make any sense, bechunga does not make any sense, I rather hold the shares. Right? Market mein bhi 100 mein mil raha hai, iski actual value bhi 100 hai, to rehne do na. Let it be with you. What's the difference if you even sell it or if you even buy new shares? Does not make any difference. Let it be. Hold whatever you have in your existing profile. Understood? And can I send a dividend? Then we had the third case that we will have a fluctuating growth also. Matlab, kuch saalon tak I will have high growth, but after some point of time my growth will stabilize, right? So can I say over here then we have two stages. Stage one was the explicit stage where there were varying levels of growth, right? So can I say we used to prepare the PV table and find out the value today, right? Can I say the stage 2 that we had was the horizon stage where the growth had now become constant, right? So can I say in this case the value at the end of that particular year, or the value at the year when the growth becomes stable, is equal to next year's dividend upon KE minus constant growth, right? So supposing if I'm doing a timeline, 0. So like it will suppose 4th year, can I say it is explicit stage, and from here you have the horizon stage. So can I say in this case it will be value at the end of year 4 equal to dividend of the 5th year upon ke minus g, right? But can I say value kis din ka mila? Can I say I got the value on this date? What day valuation do I need? Can I say I need the valuation on this date? Right. So can I say therefore this will be further discounted to arrive at value 0. Right. Aaj ki value pe aana hai na vapas. To vapas V0 pe aane ke liye is value ko abhi discount karna padega. And can I say in periods ke values already yahan par hai explicit stage mein, we have already done the present value in the PV table. So can I say the total P0 or the total IV under this model will be nothing but can I say stage 1 plus stage 2. Samjha? Matlab can I say explicit plus horizon both at V0 will be the value of my particular share today, right? Clear with this part, right? Understood? Now let us just revise some of the formulae that we have. Chalo mere saath bolte jao. RE ka formula kya hai? Your KE, sorry, as per CAPM, capital asset pricing model, can I say it is equal to RF plus beta RM minus RF, right? Can I say RM minus RF is nothing but the market risk premium, and can I say beta RM minus RF is nothing but country risk premium, right? Abhi is formula mein RF kaise dhoondne ka? Can I say RF is nothing but the return on government securities, right? So the T-bills or whatever they might have given, the government issued jo bhi hoega. Can I say this will be nothing but the future value minus the price today upon the price today. So this is nothing but the amount that I am earning over the amount that I have invested. Can I say into 100 into 12,52,365 on N, because I need to annualize it, right? The third thing that I have, abhi mere ko RM dhoondna padega, right? But RM ke pehle to beta ki baat hoti hai. Can I say beta depends whether the company security is a listed security or it is an unlisted security, right? If it is a listed security, can I say beta is equal to covariance of the security with the market upon the variance of the market, right? If it is unlisted, can I say we have got two steps? Then first one is to three steps in such. First one, take beta of proxy firm, matlab proxy firm in the market jo uska beta lo. Can I say the second step will be to deleverage, matlab remove his component of risk from the beta. Can I say this is equal to beta unlevered, which equals to beta levered, that is the beta of the proxy firm upon 1 plus debt upon equity 1 minus tax, right? And can I say now I have the beta of a pure play firm in the market, matlab without any capital risk in the market, without any debt composition in that beta, right? So now can I say my third step will be to re-leverage, that is incorporate my debt capital structure in the particular unlevered beta. So can I say this is nothing but beta levered equal to beta unlevered into 1 plus debt upon equity 1 minus tax. Can I say here it will be my data and here it will be data of the proxy firm, right? Am I clear with how we calculate beta? If it is listed, so cov xm upon sigma square m. If it is unlisted, then three steps. First, take the beta of the proxy firm, that is your beta levered. Deleverage that is remove his debt capital structure. And third step is re-leverage, incorporate your debt capital structure, right? Now, many times they may also use the word beta asset or beta equity. Remember, beta asset is equal to beta unlevered. And beta equity, since equity is risk, it is considered as beta levered. Clear with this part? Understood? Right? Abhi next kaun sa formula tha? Return from the market. We market, so what types of return do you expect? Can I say from the market what to expect is the dividend yield and the growth yield? So RM is nothing but dividend yield plus growth yield. Right? The next thing that we now need to find is how do we calculate growth? Can I say growth is nothing but the retained amount which will grow over a period of time at the return of equity of the company? So can I say growth is nothing but retention into return on equity? Can I say this is nothing but 1 minus payout ratio into NPAESA, that is net profit attributable to equity shareholders, upon net worth into 100. Right? And lastly kya aega? Can I say dividend of the next year bhi to janna padega na humko? So can I say D1 is equal to nothing but D0 plus G. Right? D1 is equal to nothing but D0 1 plus G. Right? Now if the word used in the question is paid, then the given dividend is D0. If the word used is will pay, then the dividend is going to be the future dividend, therefore D1. And if the word used is pays, that is present tense, we assume the given dividend to be D1. Ye case mein assumption likhne ka, that it is assumed that the given dividend is D1. However, if we take it as D0, our answers would accordingly change. Am I clear? And bahut bar tumko kya bolega question, EPS related data dega, and from that you have to compute your dividends. So basically they may give you some annual reports, or they may give you some future forecast or something, and you are in a position to find EPS, and from that you have to then go ahead and find your dividend. In that case, you can assume the dividend you have computed using EPS to be D1. So can I say the fourth pointer will be dividend computed using EPS is D1. Right? Assumption likhne ka. You have to write down whatever you assumed and how you assumed. Understood? Right? Are we clear? Can I say this was basically a point of view from the minority people's perspective, right? Jinko minority chahiye tha, ya those who did not want to buy the controlling interest of the company, right? But what if people want to buy controlling interest? Will they be concerned with dividend? Main agar kisi company mein 60% hold karta hu, mereko dividend se farak padta hai, or I am affected by the cash generating capacity of that particular company? Obviously the cash generating capacity of that company. In that case, what we have is the free cash flow model. Right? In this model, we have two points of view. You do the analysis from the free cash flow to the firm point of view, or you do the analysis of the free cash flow to equity point of view. The first one is known as FCFF. The second one is known as FCFE. Right? From the firm point of view, matlab can I say KD bhi aa gaya, KE bhi aa gaya, KP bhi aa gaya. So can I say the discounting rate in this case will be KC. Right? But can I say jab equity ki baat karta, I will see only cash flow of equity. Sab nikal dene ke baad equity ka jo bacha wo. So can I say the discounting rate in that case should ideally also be KE. Right? Are we clear with this particular thing? Yes. Sir, now what do you mean by free cash flow? How do we compute? Uske pehle, let us go. So for that, let us go under the FCFF approach. Free cash flow to the firm. Can I say ek aisa profit batao jis pe sab logo ka hak hota? Matlab everyone has a right on that profit in the company, be debt holder or equity holder or preference holder. Can I say हमारे पास एक ऐसा प्रॉफिट होता है एबिडा, उसमें से डेप्री निकाल दो. कैन आई से आई एम लेफ्ट विथ ईबीआईटी. इसमें से ना ही इंटरेस्ट निकला है, ना ही प्रेफरेंस डिविडेंड निकला है, ना ही इक्विटी डिविडेंड निकला है. सो कैन आई से ईबीआईटी इज वन सच प्रॉफिट विच इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेबल टू ऑल द होल्डर्स ऑफ इक्विटी, all the holders of preference, all the holders of debt in the form of interest, right? So can I say the free cash flow in this case shall be EBIT, right? But can I say tax expense ka kharcha aayega, right? So EBIT into 1 minus tax. This is nothing but the net operating profit after tax. But can I say, is this the cash flow that is available with you? No, this is not obviously the cash flow available with you, because can I say you will even make investments? Less net investment. And can I say there are ways in which a company will invest? Can I say it will either be into fixed assets or into working capital, right? So can I say this will be nothing but capital spending, which is nothing but fixed asset related spending. But can I say this spending will give me benefit in the name of depreciation? So can I say less depreciation, right? And can I say I even need working capital? But can I say day one ka 50 ka working capital is not the only working capital invested. Supposing next year I have total working capital of 60. Can I say the additional amount of 10 gets invested in working capital now? Can I say I am concerned about nothing but the change in working capital, right? So add change in working capital as such. Are we clear? So can I say for the firm, FCFF is equal to EBIT into 1 minus tax minus net investment, right? So can I say this is nothing but the free cash flow? What I need is the value of the firm now. So can I say now value of the firm will be equal to FCFF of the upcoming year upon KC minus G. CQ, kyunki main sub owners ki baat kar raha hu, sub fund providers ki baat kar raha hu, right? But mere ko to kis share ka value chahiye? Equity. So can I say value of equity will be nothing but value of firm, can I say, minus value of debt, right? So at the end, can I say the value per share, or can I say value per equity share, can I say this will be nothing but value of equity upon number of shares outstanding. Am I clear with the FCFF approach? So under that, sabse pehle you calculate the value of the फॉर्म. उसके लिए क्या चाहिए? FCFF चाहिए. FCFF कैसे मिलता है? NOPAT minus NI. NOPAT is equal to EBIT 1 minus tax. Net investment is equal to capital spending minus depreciation. Add back your change in working capital. This is the net investment you are going to make, right? From that arrive at your value of the firm, which is nothing but FCFF 1 upon KC minus G. And can I say FCFF 1 is nothing but FCFF 0 1 plus G upon KC minus G. Right, but if I got the value of the firm, I am concerned about the value of equity share. So can I say value of firm is equal to what we computed above? Value of equity abhi dhoondna padega. Can I say that is nothing but firm minus debt value? So value firm minus value debt will give me value of equity. But can I say this is the total value of all equity shareholders? I want it on a per share basis. So can I say value per equity share will be nothing but value of equity upon number of shares outstanding? Right, am I clear with this part? Am I clear with the FCFF approach? Right, now let's go to the FCFE approach. So now when we talk about the next approach, that is the free cash flow to equity, can I say I will have to now consider cash flows which are attributable or available only to the equity shareholders? Matlab can I say jo maine EBIT liya tha abhi nahi chalega, EBIT chhodke koi ek aisa profit lena padega jispe the right is only of the equity shareholders, right? And can I say one such profit is nothing but my PAT, right? If I don't have preference dividend, the PAT hoega profit after tax, right? And can I say this is the available inflows for me, right? Less net investment. Can I say this will give me the free cash flow which is available now only for equity shareholders? And can I say NI will still be the same, cap spending add depreciation, cap spending less depreciation add change in working capital, right? So can I say in this case the first step was to calculate FCFE, Can I say the next step will now be to calculate the value of equity directly? क्योंकि बात किसकी हो रही है, इक्विटी वाले की हो रही, तो वैल्यू किसकी मिलेगी, इक्विटी वाले की. कैन आई से दिस इज इक्वल टू एफ सी एफ ई वन अपॉन, कैन आई से नाउ द डिस्काउंटिंग रेट विल बी के ई माइनस जीबी, क्योंकि बात किसकी हो रही है, सिर्फ इक्विटी वालों की, एंड द कैश फ्लोज आर ऑल्सो ऑफ ओनली इक्विटी. कैन आई से दिस इज ऑल्सो रिटन एज एफ सी एफ ई जीरो वन प्लस जी अपॉन के ई माइनस जी. Right, but can I say this is the value of equity? I need the value per equity share. So can I say value per equity share now will be equal to value of equity upon number of equity shares outstanding. Right, clear with FCFE? Isme koi aur fund provider related data is only not considered, and if their contribution is not considered, can I say whatever value I will arrive at will be the equity wale ka value only? Right, am I clear with that particular part? And one more thing to tell you all, FCFFO yaar FCFE ho, you might even have a fluctuating model. Model. So what do you mean by fluctuating model? Explicit stage and the horizon stage. If you all remember that we did in EDM, abhi revise kiya hai. Understood? Ye ho sakta hai. Now the next type of strategy that we have, the next type of valuation model is nothing but Alker model. अभी एल्कर मॉडल में होता क्या है, द फर्म एट करंट स्टेटस, फर्म इज अ नो ग्रोथ फर्म. राइट, मतलब फर्म ग्रो नहीं हो रही है. फर्म अडॉप्ट्स अ स्ट्रैटेजी ऑफ ग्रोथ फॉर फ्यू इयर्स, मतलब इन दीज फ्यू इयर्स द फर्म विल ग्रो, एंड after few years firm will again become a no growth firm. Here what we are required to find is nothing but the value of strategy, matlab what is the value addition to the value of the firm on introduction of this strategy. Can I say it is simply nothing but the value post strategy less value pre strategy. Right, before strategy जो value था and after strategy जो value होएगा इस date पे और इस date पे, उनको compare करके जो भी difference आएगा, कहने से that will be nothing but the value of my strategy or the value that has been added to my firm value because of that particular strategy. Right, बराबर. Now tell me one thing, before strategy can I say company is a no growth firm? Right, बराबर. No growth firm है तो मतलब can I say जितना खर्चा करता है उसके सामने डेप्री का बेनिफिट भी ले लेता होगा. Right, can I say it does not even have any change in working capital, क्योंकि grow नहीं हो रहा है तो पैसा investment बढ़ नहीं रहा है, so there is no change. So can I say what is left is nothing but no PAT. And can I say I am talking of the firm, so can I say the discounting rate will be KC, growth and it minus 0 will give me KC. This is nothing but the value pre strategy. Right, fair value post strategy, can I say that will be nothing but the fluctuating model, explicit stage, and after that again becoming no growth, so horizon level aa jayega. Come back again, compare the two, you have your answer. Now in the exam, how to identify the given question is a Alker model based question. First statement diya aayega, firm is a no growth firm. Currently the firm is a no growth firm. This will be the first hint that will be given to you. The second hint that can be given to you is the firm is considering strategy of growth. Strategy for growth for some years. Thereafter, it will again become a no growth firm. And the third thing that will be given to you is turnover based ratios are constant. So can I say any ratio which is based on turnover, like revenue on total assets, right? Any turnover based ratio given to me in the question, if that is staying constant, can I say asset value is not increasing and neither is my revenue increasing? Kuch increase nahi, matlab, can I say it is not growing? And can I say when I arrive at a conclusion that there is no growth, can I say the firm is indirectly a no growth firm? Right? So these are nothing but your hints for Alcor model. Are we clear with this particular part? Right? The next part that we have now is nothing but the concept of right shares. We all know that under right shares, the concept is that the company gives a right to the existing shareholders of the company to purchase the additional shares of the company at a lower price as compared to the price that it would issue the shares to the outsiders, right? What we are required to do is, we are required to compute the theoretical price of the share after the right and the value of each right. Now let us take one very simple example to understand. Share price is equal to rupees 20 in the market. Barabar. Itna samjha. Company has decided to come up with a right issue of one share for every four shares held at rupees 12 per share. At a right of rupees 12. Matlab, I will give you one share at 12 if you are holding four shares. So can I say normally a person who had four shares will now have 5 shares at his disposal, right? So can I say if he exercises the number of shares held, can I say will be 4 plus 1 which is equal to 5 shares he will hold now, right? Can I say his value of investment will now ideally become 4 shares at 20 per share. And can I say add one share at 12 per share, right? Can I say rupees 92, 80 plus 12, 92, right? Can I say he has invested total 92 rupees for 5 shares? Therefore, can I say investment per share is equal to, can I say 92 divided by 5? Kya aata hai? Can I say it comes to rupees 18.40 per share? ये जो 18.40 ढूंढ के लाया ना, this is nothing but the theoretical post rights x right share price. So can I say total investment upon total number of shares held, right? बराबर. So ये तो value of the share हो जाएगा after the right. So can I say the value of the right alone will be nothing but the x right price, that is this price that you calculated, minus the right shares ka price. Right share ka to 16 rupaye mein tha, but market mein bhav 18.40 ho gaya. Matlab can I say effectively right ki value 2 rupaye 0.40 paise thi, right? 12 minus 18.40, 6.40. Can I say it will be 18.40 minus 12.00, which makes it 6.40. But can I say this was against 4 shares for which I got 1 share, right? So if I would have held only 1 share, So what would have been the cost of my one share, right? Can I say it would be 6.40 upon 4, which is equal to 1.60 per share basis, right? So value of the right for one right share is 6.40, but for every one share held, it is equal to 6.40 upon 4, that is total value of right upon the exchange per right that you are getting. Understood? तो अगर फॉर्मूला हमें लिखने को बोलो, कैन आई से वैल्यू ऑफ राइट इज इक्वल टू द एक्स राइट प्राइस माइनस कॉस्ट ऑफ राइट, राइट बराबर ऑन अ टोटालिटी बेसिस. But if I want it on the basis of per share held, so can I say it is equal to this thing? Am I clear with this particular thing that you have to remember from an exam perspective, how to calculate the value of the right? And can I say the theoretical X right price, can I say nothing but the total investment value, total value of investment post the rights upon, can I say total number of shares post right? And can I say when I am calculating this particular thing, the assumption implied that I make is right is exercised, right? Right share samjha? Clear? Gone in your heads? Cool. With this we come to the end of the discussion of the revision of the chapter of equity analysis and corporate valuations as such. Are we clear? Are all the formulae revised in your mind now? Cool. Now let's go to the next chapter.